everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Kat, and as you can see, we are definitely in a different location than we normally are. I wasn't able to film for like the longest time when I first got here because I ended up having like this horrible skin condition where just like half my face was like red and peeling, and it was just absolutely horrendous. So we only have a couple videos that we will see in this location, and then we'll be back at home. Thankfully, I am so excited to go home. But for today, we're gonna be taking a look at two Tammy Tanuka palettes that are very, very new. We have the Toad palette and the Snake palette. And I am so, so excited for these because they are absolutely beautiful. Like the shimmers, I can't even begin to describe to you guys how amazing they are. So hopefully you guys will like them as much as I do, but let's just immediately jump in with swatches because I am ready for this. So we're gonna start off with the Toad palette. And let me show you the inside, how absolutely lovely it is. It has a nice mix of neutrals, greens, that nice burgundy red. I mean, just absolutely beautiful. We're gonna see how good this lighting does here to see if we can get some beautiful shifts going on. So the first shade up is a very nice deep shade on here. Not completely black, but it's like a nice gunmetal gray type shade. Very, very nice, very solid metallic. Then we have that central green metallic, which is definitely more on the grungy, olivey side of the house, but I think that fits in really nice with those natural shades. And so far, both metallics, very, very pigmented, very opaque just on that first swatch right away. So that's really, really nice. Then we have our first matte shade, which is a nice chocolate brown shade, a little bit more on the cool toned gray side as well. Really, really nice, very beautifully pigmented on there. I will say that from the Tammy Tanuka palettes that I have used so far, they do have a little bit of fallout, which is part of why I did not do my face makeup beforehand. And so that's just something to kind of keep an eye on, because especially like some of their blue shades, I have had a considerable amount of fallout where I ended up having to like redo my entire face because of it. And so definitely do the rest of your makeup after the eye look. Don't do your face first. You're gonna have a sad day. All right, then we have what looks like a beautiful duochrome, and it starts off this like grungy copper shade and then switches over to like a kind of goldish green. So there at the top, you can see as it's trying to focus a little bit of that green because it almost matches this shade up top here. So you can see a little bit of that shift, but it goes from copper to really beautiful, deeper greenish, goldish kind of shade, but absolutely gorgeous. Really like that shade and the grunginess of it. That's going to be absolutely beautiful. All right, then the next matte shade that we have is that nice burgundy red shade. Very beautiful. I mean, definitely goes with the earthy tones, really brings out the copper in this particular shade as well. So really, I mean, this color story is coming together really, really nicely. I am very excited for this one. And we are going to do an eye look with each of the palettes. So I will have the Toad look on this eye and then the Snake look on this eye. So we're just gonna see all of the shades because I'm gonna try and use as many of the shades from both palettes as absolutely possible. All right, and then the last metallic is a really nice kind of pale peachish pink shade, which almost doesn't want to show up. It is very light toned on there. Would make for being so light though, it's solidly opaque, which is very nice. And so I think that would layer beautifully with the red shade. Also would layer very nicely with this matte grayish brown shade. I think it's a really nice kind of cool toned pink. So I think that's gonna go together beautifully with everything. Now let's take a look at the Snake palette, which is this guy. And when you open it up, look at it. I mean, these greens and I mean this kind of deeper teal blue that they added in with it, I mean all of the, this is probably like if the quality is the same as it is for the rest of the Tammy Tanuka palettes, this might end up being already in January one of my favorite palettes of the year, because I just love a good green palette. So let's just dive right into these swatches. And that first shade already looks like a duochrome, so here we go. It is a very nice green into bluish shade. Definitely more on the deeper grungy side, but really goes between green and blue on there. The first of the two matte shades is a lighter kind of pale grungy olivey green, but really, really nice shade. As always, solidly opaque on there. Then we go into the next metallic, which is that just brilliantly yellowish lime green. I mean, oh, it's so beautiful. Oh my god, I kind of want to do almost like a halo eye and just have that in the center just gleaming. All right, and then we have another duochrome, which is definitely a lighter version of this guy because it starts off with kind of almost yellowish into green and then kicks into a nice blue at the end. Yep, so this is definitely the more brilliant version of this guy up here, but very similar shifts on there between greens and blues, which is also part of why I think that having this teal blue matte shade makes a lot of sense, because quite a few of the shimmer shades do have that green into blue shift. So this ends up being significantly deeper than I was expecting. I thought it was just gonna be like a dark teal, and that is coming across as very deep navy. Also definitely on the cool tone side, but with like a little bit of a grungy undertone to it, so very nice. And then the last metallic is a really nice deep navy metallic. Definitely goes perfectly with this teal shade. Yeah, I mean, that is just an absolutely gorgeous color story, and I mean, very different than this guy, but I like both of them. I have a feeling I'm gonna like both color stories a lot, because I really love a good fall color story, which this guy definitely seems to me. And then this is just a beautiful green masterpiece. So we are gonna jump right into these eye looks because I can't wait. You know what? I think we're gonna try something a little bit different. I do want to attempt a halo eye, but we're gonna have just a whole lot of colors with it. So this is gonna be very interesting how it goes. But we are gonna start with that deeper brown shade on the inner and outer corner, and then we're gonna slowly blend that into the magenta shade. But you can definitely see how just immediately pigmented it is. Takes no effort whatsoever to place it. And I will say that this one is actually doing a really good job of not having any fallout so far. Like, you can see there's nothing at all on my cheek whatsoever. So that is really, really nice to start off with. And so now I'm gonna go into that more burgundy shade, and we're just gonna slowly start pulling that in. Losing time, I'm fading fast. I just wanna make it last. Try to let go of the past. I close my eyes, embrace the blast. Sleepless nights and headache stack. Definitely a very deep look so far. Alright, so now I think what I'm gonna do is I am going to slowly start layering some of the metallics on top. So we will start off with a deeper metallic. I think we will go into this guy first, just to really deepen it up, and then we are going to go into the more grungy, coppery gold shade, and then we will have in the very center that light pink shade, and then I think the goldish kind of shade I'm gonna kind of blend in on the bottom with the black metallic, to where it's just kind of in the center, so you have like two different types of halos going on, if that makes any sense. Restlessness to hell and back. What's my purpose? What do I grab? A slippery surface, a heart attack. Alright, so this one does have ever so slightly a little bit of fallout that landed on my cheek, but none of the matte shades had any fallout. So I think that given that it's just the metallics that are having that fallout, it should brush away pretty easily. And sometimes you just gotta believe there's something. Okay, so now we're gonna go into that more coppery and dark red shade next. That'll give you relief. There's something that'll have what you need. What you need. Oh man, that shade looks awesome. And what's really cool is that, like, just looking in the mirror, this side appears more orange and this side appears more green. So I can already see some of that shift going on there, which is really cool. All right, so we're gonna add that light pink in the center now. We're broken, it's tragic. We're not all elastic, but maybe there's magic. Believe you could have. All right, I really like how that layering is turning out on there. It is very, very cool so far. So now we're gonna do the under eye, and for that we are gonna start off with that darker shade and just pull it down, and then we will blend it into that lighter kind of greenish shade.
And I know of sadness, the anxious and panic, the infinite.
There's a part of me that almost kind of wants to bring that copper shade in on the bottom as well, and then just do the green in the very center. So I think we're gonna do that.
Vastness of all that is blackness.
All right, so far this is a very smoky eye. And so I'm gonna switch over to this eye and then we will see how that turns out. And then hopefully once I tight line and throw on mascara and finish my whole face, this will look a little bit more interesting. It is very, very deep, but in real life, I like how it turned out a lot, but I'm not quite sure how much of like the shades on the under eye are showing up in the camera right now. Because I know that the lighting is like a little sus right now. So we'll see how it goes. You know, I think for the green, we're actually gonna do almost the exact same thing, just with all of the green shades instead. So at least that way it'll be somewhat comparable in look. All right, so we're gonna start off with that darker blue teal shade for the inner and outer corner. Alright, and then from there we're gonna go into that lighter kind of olivey green tone. Hell yeah, I think that one, I mean, those two shades go together very, very nicely. So, I mean, I would almost even just combine these into a look just with the two of them. Not a halo eye like this, but like, probably do something similar. So now we're gonna get into the metallics again, and so I think we will start off in the outer corner. I think we'll go with this guy instead of the deep teal blue, just so that this one really meshes well into this one, and then this guy will go in the center. All right, I mean, this shade alone already just goes absolutely beautiful with these other tones. I mean, that is really, really pretty. It did have ever so slight a little bit of fallout, so from what I can tell from these two palettes, the matte shades don't have any fallouts, the metallics have a little bit of it. So now we're just gonna go into this absolutely gorgeous shade. Alright, and then the last thing we're gonna do is go into that really bright lime green. That is looking awesome on there. All right, I think for the under eye, what we're gonna do is we will start off on this one with actually that deeper shade, and then we will just blend that into this guy. All right, so I think we are mostly done with both eye looks, and so I am going to throw on the rest of my face, tight line, all of that good stuff, clean it up, and come back to show you guys the final look. All right, and we're back with the final look, so I'm gonna come in close for you guys. So here we are, nice and close. You guys can see some of the different shades that I have on there. For this eye, I went with a nice kind of bright green liner, and then for this one, I chose red, undecided how I feel about that. I definitely think that both looks are very, very pigmented. They would definitely turn out a little smokier than I was originally planning. I think that the colors, though, are stunning. I just need to stop trying to pretend like I know how to do a halo eye. And because if I had just stuck with like my normal tactics for how I do an eye look, I think both of them would have been stunning. I think the colors are really, really beautiful. I just, clearly, they're two different shapes because I know how to do makeup. But I think that the swatches are stunning. The colors definitely are true to how they swatch. They're true to how they look in the pan, and they are just absolutely gorgeous. I just don't know how to apply makeup, apparently. So there's that, I guess. But let me know what you guys think. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs down if you did not. Let me know either way, as we always do here. But I would love to know what you guys think of the different shades. How did they perform? I mean, I thought they were great. Very minimal fallout, which was really, really nice. So maybe it's just something about like some of Tammy Tanuka's blue shades that they have a little more fallout, but this was actually super easy, hardly any fallout, so not a whole lot of cleanup needed to happen. The swatches, I think, are absolutely stunning. I mean, the green ones, I can't live without them. They are so, so nice, but I also really, really like the fall tones of this one, and so I think both the frog and the snake palette are really, really nice, but let me know what you guys think either way. Have any of you guys picked up either palette? Have you guys picked up any other Tammy Tanuka palettes? Let me know. I would love to hear from you guys on it. And if you have not picked up any, I would highly suggest at some point picking some up because they are very, very nice. Very good quality. Not so, so expensive. And so, I mean, if you're looking for an indie brand from Russia and you're like over in Europe or something, highly suggest picking some up because they are very, very good quality. And plus, like, when you get the palettes, they come in like gift wrapping that like makes it feel so like a gift to you. And so, I mean, I really like that. I like when brands kind of do that, like, step above what, you know, what other normal brands would do. And so the fact that they, like, wrap it in this really nice paper, comes with little pictures, and is wrapped up in this nice string. I mean, it's just, it's so, so pretty. And I keep all of the wrapping from Tammy Tanuka because it is such high quality paper. And so if you like that kind of stuff, you're gonna love the palettes that they have. They do also offer them in different sizes. And so if you're not wanting the 26 millimeter pans, you can also get them in smaller. I have some that are teeny tiny. And so I really like that, where if you're just wanting to test it out, you don't have to go with the full size pans. You can go with a smaller size. And so that's really, really nice to kind of keep in mind. But other than that, if you made it to the end of the video and you have not yet subscribed, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel. Come join my family here. We talk a ton about indie brands, talk a ton about colorful makeup when I know how to apply it properly. We do tons and tons of swatches, and so if that sounds like fun for you, I would love it if you would join my family. Come join us down in the comments. We talk a ton about makeup. I give lots of recommendations of different brands down there. And so if you want to join us in the comments below, feel free, toss in any questions, comments, all of that good stuff. And other than that, you guys just go have a good one.